back. You're still on primetime on ANC. Going back to our top story this evening on the partial lifting of the European Union ban on Philippine air carriers. Joining us on the phone is Transportation Secretary Jun Abaya. Secretary Abaya, thanks for joining us tonight.
Hi, Carmina. Good evening. Good evening, Tony, too.
All right. So good news definitely coming from the EU. We were able to speak, well, Tony was able to speak to Ambassador Guy Ledoux just earlier this evening. And they see it as a good thing as well, because it's going to facilitate not just our tourists going out of the country into Europe, but hopefully some tourists as well from Europe coming into our own territory.
Yeah, it would go both ways, but the real gain here is allowing the airlines coming from the Philippines, particularly PAL, to resume flights to Europe. We know there are a lot of OFWs who work there, and hopefully we could provide a safe form of transportation coming to and from the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. Now, it's just a partial lifting of the ban, correct? Yeah.
Partial in a way, because they're tasked to really evaluate all airlines operating in the Philippines, and this is a long list. Expectedly, it would have been two airlines, particularly Cebu Pacific. Cebu Pacific didn't present this time, but generally they are reevaluated every 6 months. So I'm pretty sure Cebu Pacific will prepare well for either within the year or within a six-month period to be reckoned from, I think, June or July, where they could have themselves reevaluated, hopefully lifted too.
Okay, a lot of people, when news came out, a lot of people thought that this was basically just because PAL was able to acquire some Airbus from Europe, and this basically this investment really paved the way for the partial lifting of the ban. But to your mind, Secretary Abaya, to what would you attribute the lifting of the ban, and tell us how hard you worked so that ban will be lifted?
Definitely, it is not a business issue, not because you bought up aircraft from an EU company, you get yourself lifted. It is really a technical and safety issue. And I do believe in the professionalism and the way the management and leaders of CAF have been conducting themselves. It all started when we got the significant safety concerns of the ICAO lifted, and being the world organization that governs all aviation authorities, it seemed very logical for the EU and hopefully the FAA of the United States to follow suit within the year.
Mm-hmm. Now, standards or ban or not, all these organizations existing or not, we do have our own standards to live by. What do you think? What are the challenges still that are left for us to conquer so that in our own template will be secure, and no matter which organization takes a look into our system, we'll be confident with our system?
Definitely the evaluation of the FAA, which should come within the year, which basically to whom the Category 1, Category 2 really attaches to, remains the final test for CAAP and our airlines. And looking forward, the real challenge here is the sustainability of keeping expertise and qualified personnel to remain in the our aviation authority, particularly CAAP. This is a very challenging aspect in terms of sustainability, because the pay scales, how much do you pay people in CAAP to remain within CAAP to preserve that that expertise to really evaluate technical skills and technical qualifications as regards to safety standards, vis-a-vis the challenge of industry of drawing the same expertise to them. I think that would be the biggest challenge, and of course, maintaining the professionalism and a straightforward conduct as to strictness and compliance as to aviation convention.
Mm-hmm. And this is a final question for you tonight, Mr. Secretary. A lot of people really lauding CAAB Deputy, make that Director General William Hotchkiss as well for the way he led the organization, eventually paving the way for this ban to be lifted, although partially. What are your words for the Deputy, make that the Director General of CAAB? How would you evaluate his performance, given that he's only been there for less than a year or a little over a year?
Well, he's the right man for the job. So far, he has a perfect batting average. His credibility is quite high. Every time he says that we could make it secretary, I fully believe in him. He's a 2 out of 2. He's not that young, but clearly his energy and vision for CAAB is quite clear to really take us to greater heights and to be as competitive and as comparable as other aviation authorities elsewhere. Mm-hmm. So we're just quite fortunate that he and his team are there now helping us in the department, and they deserve more the accolades than me as a secretary. Them who really delivered the job.
Okay. Not that young. I don't think he'd appreciate that, Mr. Secretary.
He's quite a frank and honest man. He knows certain facts, but definitely he has a great vision for the authority.
Well, we appreciate you joining us tonight, Secretary Jun Abaya. Thanks again, and have a good evening.
Thank you. Thank you, Carmina, for the opportunity. Thank you.
Sure.